Hello friends, we'll be discussing the concept of stages of economic cycle. Now, we've already understood the concept of economic cycle. Now, there is a different concept which is related to the stages that we go through when we talk about the economic cycles here. Now, let us study about it, or rather, let us read out certain details about it which will help you in better understanding of this specific concept. The first stage can be called as economic boom or inflation. Now, this is one of the major important concept, or rather one of the major important cycle in this concept, which is known as inflation cycle. A boom occurs, or rather an inflation occurs, when national output is rising strongly at a faster rate than the trend rate of the growth, or rather the long-term growth rate of about 2.5% per year. So if at any point of time, if the national output of the country is going about 2.5%, which is the regular trend these days, so that is per year trend that we're talking about. If that goes about 2.5% per year, then that is known as an inflation here. In boom condition, output and employment are both expanding and the level of aggregate demand for goods and services is very high. In such an inflation condition, you understand that the demand and the employment opportunities grow at a higher rate, and just because of this, this section, or rather this specific year, or any specific year whereby you find out inflation is there, or rather we can talk about these specific employment opportunities are there, they are very high. Typically, business use the opportunity of a boom to raise output and widen their profit margins. Because of this situation itself, the business goes ahead and increases the profit margin by expanding the demand of that specific product or any other product that is in demand right now. Now, the characteristics of this economic boom or inflation can be just as follows. Strong and rising level of aggregate demand, often driven by fast growth of consumption. Because there is a rapid growth of consumption. For example, if onions are in demand right now, the reason is because onions are going to, or rather the consumption of onion is very high. But considering the prices of the onion is rising, is the reason beyond which we can understand is the supply of that specific product is very low. Hence the demand is high. This cannot be called as inflation, but consider if the supply was enough and the demand was also there, the reason in this situation is the consumption of that specific product is very high. Just like the basic necessity of salt. Even if the salt prices go up, the consumption of salt won't go down, because that is a basic necessity of our life. And without salt, you cannot make good food at all, or rather you cannot make food at all. That will be all tasteless and basteless food. So all these things, or rather the consumption of that specific product, make sure or ensures that how the demand and supply of that product will be. Rising employment and real wages. Considering that there is a lot of consumption, there will be a lot of demand for that product, you will be requiring a lot of manpower to produce that product itself. Hence, the more the manpower required, the more the employment opportunities there will be. And this doesn't just reflect in the lower level segment, it reflects in the upper level segment as well. Because to handle the lower level management, there needs to be certain management on top of it. Hence, there is also employment opportunity at that level here. High demand for imported goods and services, government tax revenues will be rising quickly, company profits and investment increase. So, if at all there is a high demand for foreign goods and products, there will be a lot of taxes which government will collect and the companies will be ready to pay, because there is a lot of consumption here. So, that's the reason why we emphasize more on Make in India goods. The reason being, if you have purchased Make in India goods, then there is less tax that is supposed to be provided to the company. Can go ahead and make a lot of profit margin out there just by selling the same products, because they don't have to go ahead and pay the taxations on those imported products there. Increased utilization rate of existing resources. That means demand, or rather danger of demand pull and cost push inflation, is the economy overheads. Now, this is one solution, or rather this is one specification that you need to understand. At any given point of time, if you figure out that the economy is overheated because of the demand pull and the cost push, so the cost that is required to maintain that production for the consumption that can absolutely overheat the economy at a given point of time, not eventually, or rather not at one specific point of time, but over the period of time it will overheat the economy. Hence, that needs to be controlled at all the given times. Now, this was about economic growth, or rather economic bloom, or rather we can also call it as inflation. On the contrary, there is other item, or rather other cycle that we can understand, is the economic slowdown, that is also known as deflation. A slowdown occurs when the rate of growth deaccelerates, but national output is still rising. National output is still growing. It is not necessary that the national output will go down. That will go into negative, and that was very, very bad for the economy. But here, national output is rising, but at a lower growth rate. Hence, the lower growth rate is known as economic slowdown here. If the economy continues to grow without falling into outright recession, this is known as soft landing economic recession. If at all there is no outright recession, whereby you can directly say, oh, you're losing your jobs, oh, there is some rate of interest, or there is no carpet, or rather there is no market capital allowed here, there is no money in the market, there is recession going on everywhere, that is known as outright recession. That specific thing whereby you're losing your jobs because the company has to cut down on cost, people are being fired, that is known as economic slowdown, and that is known as completely outright recession here. If that isn't the case, then it is known as soft landing of economic recession. If at all you're not losing your job, then in that case, that is known as soft landing here. A recession means fall in the level of real national output, that is a period when the rate of economic growth is negative. Now, what does a recession mean? A recession is a situation where there is a decrease, where there is a negative decrease in the real national output. One is the gross domestic output, that is GDP, and one is NDP. So, the national domestic output, if it goes down, then it can also be called as, or rather, GNP, the gross national output, or the gross national product. If that can be going down, or as that is going down in that scenarios or that situation, you can call there is a recession there, because you'll be losing your jobs out there. National output declines, leading to a contraction in the employment, incomes and profit. The national output completely declines, which leads to the decrease of employment, or rather which leads to certain things that can cause loss of jobs here. The last recession in Britain lasted from the summer of 1919 through the autumn of 1992. So you can expect for 2 years, basically there was a recession, there were no jobs for people, and the income earning ratio goes completely down. That is, the per capita income of every individual goes down completely, and hence it breaks down the economy of any country. When real GDP reaches a lower point, or rather reaches a low point at the end of its recession, the economy has reached the trough. Economy recovery is imminent. Now, if at all the economy is reach, or rather if we talk about, sometimes you talk about the reaching the peakest point, that is when you have reached the highest point of the saturation level, after that you go down constantly, and that is absolutely fine, because once you reach the top you're supposed to go down, and that's how the journey goes up. Now everything, if you vice versa, if you change it, if you see a mirror image of that, if the recession has reached the lowest part of it, from that part, the recovery of economy is imminent. It will go up, and that is by default, because that is the maximum level until which you can go down, or your economy can fall down completely. So that is one point. Now, the characteristics of economic recession, or rather economic slowdown. Declining aggregate demand for output. In boom, there is aggregate demand, that is increasing demand. Here, there is declining demand. Contracting employment, rising unemployment. Sharp fall in the business confidence and profits, and decrease in the capital investment spending. Because of all these things, you know that you are going to lose your job. You know that the market won't have much money. Investment will be very low, and hence that will lead to a loss of economic growth. Destocking and heavy price discounting. If at all recession comes in, there will be depricing completely, or rather we can talk about heavy discounts being made available to people. You see that this kind of thing happens only during, or rather we can call it as during festival season. You cannot call that as recession, absolutely. But those are discounts, those are nominal discounts that are offered. But if you see that a TV worth rupees 1 lakh is being sold out at 10,000 rupees, or it is being sold out at 5,000 rupees, that is known as heavy discounting that is given. Although that's a hypothetical statement, but this was just to give you an idea about how sharp discounts are given here. Reduce inflationary pressure and falling demand for imports. That means inflation pressure is very low. That is, growth in the economy is very low and there is a lot of pressure here. Increase government borrowing, lower interest rates from central bank. There is a lot of borrowing that is done by the government from the central bank at lower rate of interest, such that, or rather, this is because to make the working capital required for the daily funding here. The last stage of economic recession is depression, at which the economic activities touches its low point in terms of the production, employment, saving and investment. Now, the last stage of deflation would be whereby the companies, or rather individuals, reach the lowest point of the productivity of their engagement, or rather of any of this thing which leads to growth of this specific company or that specific individual. So these are the basic things that we can discuss when it comes to the stages of economic cycle, that is inflation and deflation and their characteristics. So this is all that we had in economic, or rather stages of economic cycle. Thank you.